Hello everybody and welcome to Dead Fantastic, game number 8, Clash of the Titans. So my team is on 7-0 and I'm playing Shaeffer's team, which is 1-6 drawn 1. We've got guard on both mummies, stand firm mummy, mighty blow piling on white, guard white, agility 4 ghoul. I've kept my minus movement ghoul, just because, you know, having a blodger, I think, is better than not having a blodger against Shaeffer, with it being the crunch match. Obviously, I've got a rookie ghoul as well. 13 players total is quite good. And of course, I will buy a wizard, because it's a crunch match. And we're playing Blood Bowl 2, and that's how Blood Bowl 2 works. And then let's have a look and see what he's got. He has got a strength 4 werewolf, which is obviously terrifying. And that's his record. And block werewolf, which is pretty good. Guard on both fleshies. Thank you very much for the host, Richard T. Which is obviously really powerful. Tackle on both whites to try and get my ghouls. A guard and a wrestle ghoul, which is interesting that he went wrestle after guard. I would have definitely gone block after guard. But obviously, if I'd taken wrestle, I would have taken guard on the double still. And he's only got 12 players for this match. And because we're the same TV, he can't buy a bribe with his 90 grand in the bank. So that's pretty good. Hello, cornflakes and milk. And that Pedro Jack is why I didn't get rid of my extra cash, yeah. I'm getting rid of it by just buying a wizard. And hope that I get 100k in winnings over the next two matches, like including this match and the next one. I hope I make 100 grand so I can just buy a wizard against Ducky as well. Because why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I? It's so overpowered to be able to purchase wizards. It's ludicrous. It's ludicrous that we have an even TV match and I've just bought a wizard. Yeah, of course you knew the wizard was coming. I mean, what I could have done is I could have sacked a zombie to go down to 11, to go down to 12 players, and then only bought a wizard for 110k, which would have then almost guaranteed the wizard against Ducky. That was something I considered. But I think 13 players, I like 13 players, because I think, you know, obviously Shaeffer's a good coach, but one of the ways I can lose this game is werewolves kazzing the shit out of my team. So I think if I go 13 players, it's a bit more reliable, isn't it? Yeah, hello VIP Bleeding Hippie. Yes, of course I'm abusing Blood Bowl 2. I mean, why wouldn't you? It's there to be abused, isn't it? Oh, he's kicking. Interesting. Sehr interessant, as they say in Germany. Bribes all the way, Ducky. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, look, I'm going to spend all my money against Ducky. I make no bones about that. Obviously, he's probably the best coach, you know, in this division, I would say. Not having seen Hon and Shaeffer play, I know that Ducky's very good. Current champion ladder champion. So, yeah, obviously I haven't seen them play, so I am biased. But before coming into it, I obviously knew they had to be good to be the current champion and a multiple time champion. But you know, Ducky was the only one that I've seen play, and I know Ducky is really good. The moment of truth, yeah, it's crazy, isn't it? 7 weeks, and it all comes down to this. I mean, the next three games are going to be really hard for me. Shaeffer, Hon, and Ducky, definitely. He played farm star player points. Yeah, that was unbelievable. That was unbelievable, Ducky. He got so lucky. He got so lucky to draw that game that he drew 2-2. Holy shit, that he went for that farm in the star player points and it paid off for him. Paid off for him big style, didn't it? Oh, that was unbelievable that he played the farm style player points, and that would have never worked for me. I know that for fucking sure. But it worked for him. Right, so what do we want to do here? If he gets a blitz, is this the movement 5-1? Yep, so I don't want to blitz the movement 5-1, obviously. Let's make it the block guy that gets blitzed. The crap block guy that gets blitzed. If there's a blitz. Yeah, I'm obviously going to try and blitz this one and pile on him. Bloodbowl 101, isn't it? Right. This looks okay. So yeah, three dice this guy, three dice this guy, two dice this guy. Blitz him and then hope for the best. Good strategy. Interesting strategy. Cotton, let's see if it pays off. Get the ref. Ooh, a bribe. But I've got 13 players, which is actually all right, isn't it? Right. So, that's a bit shit, because obviously I'm in danger of getting served if I move him forward. But I can go there and then go back and then protect in. So it's not so bad. This guy can move over here first. Yeah. Right. 3D. Ooh, got him. KO'd. Good for you. Ooh, got him. KO'd. Good for you. On your push. Right, so I could actually go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and blitz him now, because he is at a more relevant position, isn't he? Even though he's the shit one. I think it's probably worth it hitting him even though he's the shit one. Stunned. Pile on. Oh, sweet animation. Injured. No regen. Please. Shit, regens. But still, three guys off the pitch. I've had worse turns. Alright. Course. I've got to reroll it because I just need the ball, don't I, with all of his shitters around there. Now I can move this guy back. To make this guy get the hit. Or this guy. Right, so we've got an L screen. Remove three players, turn one. Looks good. Hello, VIP Senai89. Jimmy paid me full well. Yeah, I love the white pylon. Yeah. I've had worse turns. Yeah. Yeah, fouled white. Yeah, unfortunately, the bribe. Yeah, means that he's probably going to get. And I've just reminded him of it. Damn you, a large thud. Well, the thing is, if I didn't pile on, I get clawed and fouled, don't I? That's the thing, Valenik. So I could have just not blitzed, or I could have blitzed and not follow. I could have blitzed him and then run back. I could have blitzed him just with Mighty Blow and run back, but I wanted to take out the guy who was going to hit a ghoul, you know. Yeah, it's not the pylon. Yeah, exactly. I could have blitzed this guy and retreated. Yeah, three removals is pretty damn good, but yeah, he's probably going to get a removal. He's probably going to get a removal, isn't he? Foul with a ghoul. But if his ghoul gets sent off, obviously only about a 1 in 18 chance, then it's pretty good. And also it means that he's not paying attention to the board. The board state, as it were. You know, my mummies can do some work, can't they? three players up. But yeah, maybe I should have just blitzed him and retreated. That would have been a play. Blitz him and then just come back. He'd have been stunned. But then he would have had a white here, wouldn't he? I guess I could have just done something. Shaeffer took a babe, but we both got a bribe from get the ref. Yeah, this is a way I can lose here, isn't it? A plus three foul. But he can't actually get him back to assist. So he's only getting a plus two foul in here. Without dirty player. So it's not too scary, but obviously only I'm right. Also, it leaves him a wolf exposed to a counter hit if he does it. Yeah, it's only 1 in 18 though, isn't it, to be spotted and fail the bribe. So, stunned, sent off. Oh, bribe gone. Bribe gone. Protect the wolf. See you later, mate. Wow, reroll there. Interesting. Right. So let's. I mean, okay, it's not very good, obviously, where it is, but I've got to make this three dice first to see what happens. Right. So now the guard can come in here. I'm going to put this guy up here so that he can't get assists on the on the mummy. Right, 2D this guy. Obviously got to reroll it if it's a 1 in 9. Which it ain't. So now what do? I guess I block into the blitz, don't I? Okay, and then, so I can either blitz the tackler or blitz the wolf. If I blitz the tackler, then I'm countering his assist for the foul. Probably worth it, his wolf's tied up on him anyway. Come on. No way. Holy shit. All right, good. Ah, Scheiße. Not the greatest start.
Greed is good. Greed is right. Greed works.
Not bad. Not bad. Gandhi's the one doing the fouling, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, exactly, bleeding hippie. I've got two reserves, don't I? Losing a zombie is not bad. I was thinking of doing that Targaryen tantrum, yeah, I was thinking of doing that. But then I figured I wanted to tie up his tackler, otherwise his tackler gets to blitz a ghoul, doesn't he? And I did really didn't want his tackler to blitz a ghoul. Because that again is one of the ways I can lose, isn't it? Yeah, that's what I was. Oh shit, the baby. Yeah, fuck. Shit the bed. I mean, a KO is as good as a Kaz almost, isn't it? Although he's going to have two chances to bring him back if I score. I would always love to have Kazed it no regen, but he's off for the drive at least. So now it's just trying to set up hits on his tackler and his werewolf and ghoul, aren't I? If I can, ghouls. The agility 3 players, I don't really give a shit about his flesh golems because they can just get based by my mummies and then my mummies are just stronger than them, aren't they? Don't feel good about using both rerolls in the first two turns, but just got to play a bit safer, haven't I, after that. It's not the end of the world. Yeah, the babe has got a good chance with 3 KOs. No Kaz, that's the thing. That is the bad thing, the Kaz regen. The 3 KOs will probably... Well, there's a good chance of 2 coming back and then the other one isn't there. And even if 1 comes back, there's a decent chance of 2 coming back. If no come back, there's a good chance of 2 coming back. So there's a good chance he'll have 11 players second half. He's also got 12 players anyway, so... Also, moving this guy into there made that if he pushes him there, he's got to push him to here, hasn't he? Which... Yeah, he's gonna do everything to try and get a 2-dicer on this mummy, which is fair enough, isn't it? Was a bit shit giving up a block there. Maybe I should have blitzed him instead of the white. Yeah, I'd just like to be up men, wouldn't I? With him only having 12 and me having 13, I would have liked to have been. I'd like to be up men. I would love to have taken out his strength 4 werewolf, obviously. So yeah, he's engineered a 2D there, which is fair enough, and he hasn't even given up a lot positionally to do it either. Unfortunately, I will stand firm. Good, he doesn't have guard. So I'm getting to pom his wolf. Right, so what do I do here? I probably do want to put a guy in there, don't I? That seems okay. Do I want to make fouls? Not really. I can't reroll anything though, can I, this turn? So I've got to think a little bit. I could put him in the guard in there. Could put the guard in here. Doesn't really do a lot, but... Got to think about keeping the ball safe, haven't I? I want to block this block, but can't reroll if it fails. So I think these 4 will protect the ball in the interests of keeping the ball safe. Giving away a 2D to him, though, is really bad. Is this enough of a concession to keeping the ball safe? Probably. I probably don't need to guard it around this side, do I? And this is guarding it around this side. So this is good enough, right? Let's make this blitz here. Shit. I can't re-roll it. Okay. So now I've got to slam in this guard. Got to slam the guard in, haven't had to protect all of that. Pow him. And yeah, I think that's good. Please kill that plus strength wolf. Yeah, I really wanted to, VIP bleeding hippie. I really did. I really did want to kill it. Hello, Andy Davor. Yeah, I did. I only took the wizard. We both got a bribe through get the ref, and Shaeffer paid for a babe. This is good, isn't it? He's all based up. Nearly all based up. Maybe I could have tagged him with a zombie. Yeah, both golems guard first. Interesting, isn't it? I can see the point because yeah, I'm enjoying the UKBBL. Yeah, Valenik. Yeah. Yeah, amazingly. The UKBBL winning them all. I'm not enjoying the OCC so much. Oh shit, I didn't make it 1080p. Apologies to YouTube for it being 720. I didn't mean to change it to 1080. With it being a big match. Yeah. The thing is, the guard first, I can see the point because, you know, it's all about you getting your werewolves not banged on, isn't it? If he didn't, and plus, like, you know, he's up against a lot of orcs and undead in this group. So, you know, block on them isn't really going to be as useful as guard in many ways. I think they're getting hit by mummies a fair bit, which block isn't defensive. One dicer. Nicht so gut. Another one dicer. Ah, scheiße. Is he going to go the one dicer into a two dicer? Dirty dog. Fails. You couldn't reroll that, could he? No. Oh god, get banged on. Yeah, Jim Shaman. Yep. Can't go for... Oh, it's a two dicer? No. No, it's a one dicer. I guess I want to blitz with my mummy, but I don't want to use rerolls. Oh, one dice blitz gets the pow! Unbelievable! Unbelievable, blitz without block. Blitz without the blitzer. Unbelievable, Jeff. No, I think I'll blitz him with a ghoul. Ooh, danke. Oh, fuck. I fucked it, haven't I? Right, I blitz him with the white then. Because I can't afford rerolls here. I can't afford to reroll that. Otherwise, I could come round and blitz there and get another block. Obviously, he's going to block him. Pals is Dodger. Right, get him, lad. Fuckhead. So if you can block him on two dice, so I need to get this ghoul around to tag him. This zombie can tag him. I don't have to move forward yet. Try to get him. Both down on no balls. No balls. No balls confirmed. Is this worth it? Would then mean that he couldn't two dice the guard guy. But if he does two dice the guard guy, he's into an uphill anyway. Nah, it's probably best just to punch him, isn't it? Stun. Random ghoul block. That worked out pretty well. Yeah, UKBBL, OCC are the two that I'm in. And like, the OCC is the biggest league, I think. UKBBL seems better for me because I'm just doing better, you know, whereas I've been absolutely hammered in the OCC. So. You know, I've been absolutely hammered in the OCC, and I've done pretty well in UKBBL, so I'm liking that more. But I think they're the only two leagues I'm in. Oh, there's the Twitch Bloodbowl League as well, which I'm also in. OCC is horrific. VIP the Waitrix, absolutely awful for me. First game I got three players killed, and including a ghoul and a white. And everybody in my league, bar one guy, has got a good team, and it's just going to be absolutely disgustingly difficult. Absolutely disgusting. We're going to get some mighty blow hits next turn, hopefully. And I don't know whether to do another foul, because, you know, obviously I do don't want to go to 10 second half. He's going to get his LOS blocks. And a foul if he's still got 12 players, which he probably will. So I don't really want to get another guy sent off. I think I'll just save my bribe for the second half now and save my fouling for the second half. Because obviously this guy is the one who wants to be fouled the most. And this guy. Funnily enough, the two of the guys I want to foul the most are off the pitch. So. No, he gets to hit him. Holy shit. Risky business, though, isn't it? Frenzy trap. He's making some one dices. Obviously, he hasn't got much choice, but if he gets the push here, he's in a world of hurt, isn't he? Oh, shit. Oh, well. Wow, that's... Yeah, I read she was improving, too. Oh, scheisse. Yeah, 2016's quite the year, isn't it? He's in a bad shape here, isn't he? If he does this, oh, he gets the push. So he's freed up his wolf to do something. But what that is unclear. Pretty great getting three removals turn one, wasn't it? It was unbelievable. Basically made, he had no chance of stopping me scoring. It's just become, well, okay, I shouldn't get too confident, but basically he can't do much to stop me scoring, can he? And it's mostly just been about him trying to minimize getting banged on. Is the order of the day. Wow, Dr. Mahabosco, pretty harsh. Come on, 1-9 this. I always won in 9 Ghoul Dodgers. Never made a dodge with a ghoul that wasn't a 1-9, ever, in my life. Maybe I'm lying. Mm-hmm. So he's made a decent effort to do something here, hasn't he? I could block him. 3D him first. Yeah. Let's 3D with this guy first. I really need the power though. Got him. Injured. We saw the animation, so there's no regen. Which means no foul on turn 8, which is good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so I can hit him. Just move him there for the assist. Do the reliable block first. Got him. Obviously blitz. Blitz the wolf with the pommer. High level strategies here. And pile on, obviously. Why on earth would I not pile on? He can block him. So, actually, he can probably roll some dice and get a hit on the ball here if I go too far. I guess I'm safe here and I can go forward next turn. If I get a knockdown here, it's pretty good. And I can move that side. Good. I could even foul him. I mean, you can make some dodges here. I could cage up. The stand firm guys are a little bit annoying, aren't they? But I can move up here. Yeah. He's not in range to surf anyone. Still got plenty of time. 3 turns. Shame the pylon did nothing. Would you get jump up on piling on Mighty Blow? Yes, absolutely, Zolo 9. That is the dream. That is the absolute dream. Yeah, this is going about as well as it could have, yeah. Very true, Will King 15. His strength 4 wolves out of the picture. Got a bribe magically for the second half, thanks to the thing. His is gone. Only lost 1 player, but got 2 reserves. He's got 11 max. Decent chance of it being 10 for the second half. Not a high chance, but there's a chance of it being 10 for the second half. So, yeah. Hello, VIP von Steinberg. Well, the reason is that that's the side his wolf and ghoul are. Johnny Robles? Yeah. It was because that's the side where both those are. I've got the movement to switch sides, no problem. Still. So... that was basically it. If I'd moved here, he could have just dodged. He didn't even need a dodge, and he could have made a dodge with his werewolf to get a 2-dicer. Which, yeah, don't jinx it. Look, if I don't score, then he's got less players on the. He's got less chance of having a full 11. So, it's not even that bad if I don't score. But obviously, it's not good if I don't score. But yeah, it's going pretty well. Obviously, I'd be silly not to say it's going well, wouldn't I? It's clearly going about as well as it could have gone. Yeah. I did use my rerolls pretty quickly. That's the only bad thing. You're going for a one dicer. Try and pow me blodger. Skulls. Skulls out. Pows me blodger. Unbelievable, Jeff. It was my movement 6-1 though, so that's good. That's something at least. Tackle paying off for him. Yeah, although I did go the side of the tackler who made a stun. But as I say, super easy to switch sides. So that's okay. I could even foul his wolf as well. TBH, ah, he's going to dodge him. Fair enough. Without a reroll, so it was a little bit risky. I'm not going to GFI to blitz with him. So I think I'm going to blitz him. With 3 dice. Could move him up there first. Yeah. Let's move the ball. Play safe. He can blitz him. He can block him. I want to tag him. But on the other hand, I want to keep the ball safe, don't I? As safe as possible. So I could 2-dice him. Yeah, let's try to just not be stupid. Not being stupid is probably a good tactic right now. Powers his blodger with mighty blow. Dead. Yes! Oh my god, it gets me a zombie. Oh my god, I can foul. Yes. Another foul. Love it. Right. Power the other one. Oh my god. I can foul next turn as well. So that's good. Both down on no balls? No. No balls. No balls confirmed. He could dodge and GFI to foul him, but I'll foul next turn with this guy. Maybe the wolf if I'm lucky. Oh, yes. It's getting brutal now. Yeah, it is a little bit. Yeah, zombie without a head. Crazy, isn't it? Yeah. Holy shit. This is outrageous, isn't it? To be fair, that's pretty lucky when you make 3 cars. And 1 regen, which is reasonable. And 3 KOs. It's pretty lucky, isn't it? And obviously should be able to make 1 more foul now. It's a shame that the kill happened on the second Kaz happened on turn 6, because if it had obviously happened earlier, it would have been more fouls. But it's obviously good that it happened. Guard Gone is amazing, yeah. Yeah, and Wrestle, to be fair, because Wrestle can get the ball loose, can't he? He could have just, you know, if I just pushed him, he could have 1-diced here and then like made a 5+ dodge in, minus 2 dicing with Wrestle. It wouldn't have been the worst thing in the world. Had to reroll that, because otherwise his wolf's getting punched. Yeah, VIP von Steinberg. I love killing players in Bloodbowl. That's my favourite thing to do. And it's mostly why I enjoy Bloodbowl. Oh, danke. Can I have all of them? Mm-hmm. Danke. It's pretty cool, this. Right, I'll just eat it on stream. I don't know. Fashbinder, I'll wait until half time. Because knowing Fashbinder, he'll just until it's over, Fashbinder will just screen cap me eating. Yeah, when I'm happy, you know it's bad. Yeah, that's a true story. Yeah, like he could. The wrestle being out is pretty decent. One dice here could go badly, couldn't he? He's got block. Gets another crack at it. Uh-oh. Armor 7. Injured. Regen's worked, though, because there was no animation. Good. Fucking hell. Scurry. Yeah, protects with a fleshy. Makes sense, man. Right. So I guess the first thing I do is fuck off. I don't know why I'm typing things on the stream. Replay is only like the AV break animation is only shown if regen fails. Right. So put two guys in here. Put him there. Put guard in here. Two dice him. Foul him with one assist. How him. Could have pushed him there and fouled him with Morris's, I guess, but obviously I just want to hit this little fuck. Got him. Pile on incoming. KO. He's eight. He comes back 8 times out of 9, so piling on is better. Alright. And then he could go there and I could foul him with plus 2. With a GFI. But then that's his sure hands guy. And he can't regen. No way, Pedro. Yeah, foul the no regen player. Yeah, exactly. Try to win. I mean, it's about winning, not crippling his team, isn't it? Hello, VIP, Mr. Yamandem. This GDA server down. No, it was just good over Christmas. I'm always going to be primary Blood Bowl, you know. It's just... this actually genuinely couldn't be going worse. Well. Well, the S4 dog could be... dead. Any excuse to pile on? No, to be fair, look, he does come back 8 times out of 9, right? Even without babes, he comes back 3 out of 4, which makes the pile on about even. Because obviously he comes back from half of the day. Yeah, all those kills could be Kaz. Yeah, look, we've all seen games where crazy things happen. So, it could always be going worse, yeah. It can always be going worse. Holy shit. Like, as bad as my first OCC match was with 3 deaths, I could have had 5 deaths. In fact, let me link you the absolute, to anyone who complains about dice ever. I mean, he wasn't complaining about dice, really, was he? He was just saying it was going badly, which it was. What's he called? What's that card in Magic where it's a counter spell that costs one less for each card in your graveyard? Circular Logic. Right. Circular Logic has this on his thing. Where is it? Maybe it's a blog. It's about. I'll find it on Fumble. Holy shit! It was the craziest game you've ever seen in your life. So I could block him, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 3 dice, and then blitz him. That seems better, doesn't it? Than not. Oh, I don't get the. I don't get the follow up. I'd have to. Kazim. So maybe I should just blitz him. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'd basically have to Kaz him here to get the blitz him. Might just push him though. Oh, now I've blocked off the way anyway. I moved that guy to the wrong square. Should have moved him to there. Ah, well. There's no way in hell I'm going to make a GFI to punch him. No way in hell. Turn 8 foul on no balls. Yes, Fleek and Wrath, I do indeed play. Well, I used to play Magic. Was one of the highest rated players in England, believe it or not. Two right. Come on, we need fails. Ah, shit, the dog's up. Obviously the dog. The dirty dog is the most important one. On my team, I guess my Pommer's my most important player. Oh, no, he can regen, can't he? I guess it's the agility for ghoul. Right, he's got both movement 8, so I guess he could potentially do a one turn. But it's not super likely, is it? Still give him a bit of a gap. I've got to do this, haven't I? Right. No Dark Elves, yeah. Unlimited, yeah, VIP, the Waitrix. Basically, the combo was probably Kiki Cheeky Mirror Breaker. And then you had like 1/4s, in fact, never mind 1/1s. There were 1/4s that when they... I can't save them, though, Pedro Jack. It's not worth saving a... What's it called? Garbage time one, is it? There was a 1/1, yeah, there was a 1/1 as well, wasn't there? There was a 1/1 and a 1/4. And both when they come into play, you tap or untap target creature, and you so tap is moving the card from like this to like this. So you would Kiki Jiki would create a copy of the creature, which when it came into play would untap Kiki Jiki, and then there was ways to get, and then when he made it had haste, so you could do that, and then you'd make millions of them and stuff like this. And yeah. It was pretty good. So yeah, he made one that had haste, that was right. So he makes it, and then it untaps him, and then... So it's just like a two-card combo. Basically, there's loads of combos in Magic, but all the best ones are like two-card combos, because obviously they're so much more reliable to only have to draw two cards out of a 60-card deck than three cards out of a 60-card deck. Right, let's see Circular Logic. The good job is I don't have to use a fucking... don't have to use a Apo, so I can do things whilst my opponent's turn. And this, holy hell, if this isn't the craziest match you've seen in your life. Okay, you're not going to see it, but you're going to see the match result. If I would defy anybody to show a crazier result from a match than that, that is, whenever you think a game can't be going worse, look at that game and think, okay, it could be going worse. Because that wasn't a Clawpom team that did that to him. It was 1260 Dark Elves with no kill skills. Exarch Twin, ah yeah, there you go, yeah, that's the one, yeah. Exarch Twin, yeah, yeah, Twin, same thing. He's going for the foul still, even though he might be down to 9 players, second half. No, he didn't go for the foul. He only thought about it. Right, hopefully this guy fails and he's down to 9, no, 10. Yeah, 9 if he fails, no. So he's on 10. 10 versus 11. Got the wizard, got all my best players. Not going too bad. Oh yeah, thank you. I'll have it after the match. Right. So seeing as I wanted to make him blitz a zombie, but I guess I'm not going to have the chance because I've got too many good players. I don't want to be able to blitz a ghoul. Or do I? I guess I do. Even though he's getting a blitz in with tackle. Which gives him a decent chance, so he's got both tacklers still. He's blitzing armor 7 anyway with wolves. If I put my mummies out there, they're just getting hammered. With the strength 4 one, that's the thing that makes it so stupid, doesn't it? But I guess he would get hit back in return. Unless he dodged away. Oh man. No, I did 8 fouls with dirty play. Oh, fair enough, Petro Joe. Maybe I could get the mummies hit. Maybe I could put them forward to protect the LOS. And then put these here. Does this work? That protects the mummies. I really don't want mummies just to get fucking can opened by armor 7. Can opened. No, fuck it. Let him blitz. Let him blitz. Ghouls, I don't mind. This defenseless one, though, could be him, couldn't he? And then I can foul with dirty player. Alright, fuck it. Thing is though, Pedro Jackie, in that case, yeah, it was a little bit, because I was only toying about it, but yeah, quick snap. Wouldn't fuck it that much, because they're still fucking mummies, so it's still hard to 2-dice them, isn't it? Like, it is still hard to 2-dice mummies, even if you quick snap into them. But he could obviously, yeah, he could have 2-diced the guys. He could have 2-diced the both ghouls with tackle would have been pretty bad. And then that would have got him assists for hitting the mummy. So yeah, quick snap would have absolutely fucked it. Good point. Right, I'm just going to turn on my camera for a little bit while I eat a thing. I was just going to eat so that Fash didn't screen cap it. Because you know what he's like. Right. I'm back. Don't worry. Quick snap. So yeah, he got the quick snap that would have fucked me. He's got his sure hand still, but hasn't got the other goo, which is good. And obviously with a wizard, he's got to carry with a sure hands, because otherwise, if he was carrying with a strength 4 wolf, he was going to get fucking bolted. I could still bolt the strength 4 wolf anyway, couldn't I? Just to foul him. With a bribe. Wouldn't even be bad. Could fireball him. He's gone for the interesting strategy of leaving, you know, maybe allowing the split in team here. Because I do have 3 ghouls, which are pretty fast, and a wizard. Yeah, VIP, Mr. Yemendem. Almost the winner of this, but there's still a ways to go. I could still lose the last three games, right? It's possible, because my last three games... No, I didn't use it, Dr. Mama Bosco, because I had reserves. Because I had reserves, I didn't use my bribe. His bribe's gone, but I still got mine. Because I have reserves. Lightning bolt the string 4 wolf just because he's a motherfucker. No, he's gone for the movement 7-1. Dirty dog. But it's with his movement. It's with his movement 5-1, so it's not ideal for him. Yeah, I could lose the last three games. It's possible. Obviously, Ducky's good. And Hon's good, and the other guy's got orcs. I don't know how good a coach he is, but he's got orcs, so he could do things. Alright, just a stun, that's alright. Yeah, wolves can... Strength 4 wolves can definitely murder the shit out of your team. It's a bit... Not so much with Norse, obviously, because of your armor 7 anyway. Not so scary, a strength 4 wolf against Norse, but terrifying against, with like, if you've got mummies and shit that really don't want to be turned into armor 7 shitters. I mean, he can almost 3 dice. If he put his flesh golem there, he could have started off with a 3 dice from his wolf, which is just, quite frankly, is outrageous. He's going to get to 3 dice now with him. No, he's not. Alright. Stuns. Hello, it is. Merry Christmas. He's got 10, Pedro, Jack. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No, he's got 9. Wait, no, he's got 10. He's got 10, him as well. He's got 10. He had 12 players, and he's down 2. He made all 3 of his KO rolls, which with babes isn't unrealistic, is it? Though it would have been nice if one had failed. $135 in chat. You got one from me, it is as it is. Merry Christmas. One and all. Yeah, Christmas is over, but you know, not since I've streamed. 3 dice from the thing. Yeah, it could be a 5-man, could be a 4-man fireball. Because one of them is mine. So what a difference here. He's made 3 stuns so far, which is very good, obviously. He's pretty lucky to make 3 stuns. But... And a KO. But it doesn't quite match my 3 KOs, does it? But it's still good. It's still a very good start for him. 3 stuns. It's still very good. You can't complain about that. And it's 10 versus 10 now. Attrition fireball the 2 doggies. Oh, shiza. No, I'm not going to attrition fireball the 2 doggies. Yeah, back to even men's. I mean, a KO on three stuns. If this had been the first half, I'd have been raging. But obviously my first turn was ridiculous. Okay, so clearly what I'm going to do here is move him in there so that this is now... you know, strand his tackler on a mummy is good, isn't it? Get the guard there. He can blitz him, then retreat. Death. I've got my soundboard, didn't even use it. It's not even men anymore. Right. Not bad. Come on, Chalotti, if the kicking team scored on turn 6, and the following kickoff is a riot, do you count as turn 7? I honestly don't know, Carl Ancelotti. I think you don't count it as turn 7. I don't know. It's hard for me to answer that right now. Third double on Wolf, you take Jugger. Yeah, I guess so. I guess you would take Jugger. Though somebody... Yeah, two Kaz, he's got a chance, VIP Bleeding Hippie. Two more Kaz to level would be amazing, wouldn't it? Get a tackle for playing Ducky and Hon would be amazing. Would be actually amazing. In fact, I should try and score on him if I can get another Kaz with him. He's on 15, I'm obviously not going to go for a completion with him. Or a touchdown with a mummy either. But he's on 13, he wouldn't mind scoring. And he's on 28, so he wouldn't mind scoring as well. Yeah, he's gonna spank the mummy now, maybe, isn't he? Looks like it. But I kind of had to, didn't I? I couldn't protect everybody. Maybe I could have exposed him, but then I wanted to protect the better mummy. Because I had to protect one of the mummies, didn't I? And seeing as this was easier because he was already in contact with somebody, I wanted to protect him more than this one, as well as him being more valuable anyway. Juggernaut isn't bad on a wolf. The only thing is the strength 3, aren't they? It's much better if you're strength 4 to get Juggernaut. But yeah, the guy who won the fucking Fumble Cup had a leader on a wolf, and it was his first double. Can you imagine that? I saw it is, but I don't answer it right now. Are you just you're just doing it for other people? All right, good. Yeah, someone else can answer that because it's hard. You know, I mean, this is the maybe deciding match of the division. I don't really want to think about be distracted. This is into a one die here, isn't it? This is into a one die if he gets the push. And gets the pal. Maybe I should have put the piling on guy behind him to dissuade the blitz. I couldn't know I blitz with him, so I couldn't do it. Obviously, I'm just going to punch him anyway, though, with this guy. Hello, VIP audiences. Oh, fuck, Kergal said, don't look at chat in my turn. No, I'm reading it in my opponent's turn. But still, you've got to think in both turns, don't you? I think in both players' turns. All through my opponent's turn, I'm looking at the board, aren't I? That's why, like, my turns don't take long, because I've got all of my opponent's turn to analyse the board and see what's happening. He's dodging away anyway. Dirty dog. Strength 4, doesn't even want to tangle. Dirty dog. Yeah, got to shout out the VIPs, yeah. And absolutely VIP Ori Lenses. Got to shout out the VIPs. But, in terms of trying... Yeah, I'm trying Tomo 5000. I do try to do that. I'm trying to do that more. It's my team I lose tragically. Alright, fair enough. Right, so who do I pile on here? I could pile on him. But to do that, I've got to give up a Garda. I've got to sacrifice a Garda to this strength 4 fuckhead. But that would be a bit of a frenzy trap anyway. This guy can come in here. That's not a bad place, is it? Then he can 2D him. Right, these are going to stand up. I could blitz him. But again, it's hard with the guard, isn't it? This seems a beautiful move in here, doesn't it? No, this one even. That seems a beautiful move. I don't really want to foul with him. Get the guard in there. I'm going to get the guard in and blitz this guy, I think. Right, let's just get him back. Got him. Obviously have to pile on so he doesn't get punched by a dog. No. He can go there. That's two people that I've played have said. That's the best. It is a very good animation. Push. He's got to stand firm here, hasn't he? Yeah. That's not so bad, is it? This stun's pretty cool. Because it takes him out and lets me push that side, doesn't it? So now it's hard for him to blitz this guy, isn't it? With a tackler. Pretty hard now. It's hard for him to reverse. It's hard for him to go forward. It's hard for him to do anything, really. So hopefully, his line will collapse a bit this turn and then can wizard and get the turn off soon. Yep. Would have been good to have got a kill, wouldn't it? Or at least an armor break out of it. But still. Nine. I've got 10, he's got 9. And I do have the bribe. But just couldn't use it last turn. We'll try to use it next turn. And it's still got the wizard as well. So. Very interesting. The Waitrix. The Waitrix should like it because it's like the Matrix, isn't it? Free the wolf and screen downfield with those guys. It's not easy though, is it? It's not easy. I don't think it's easy. I don't think it's an easy turn for him. Because there's frenzy traps in different places, isn't there? That was pretty huge that he got to stand firm there. Yeah, the movement 5-1. I thought this was, wasn't this the movement 5-1? That this is the movement 5-1. So yeah, this white's a bit isolated, which is good. But that's the good part about him going down this flank. I really hate that flesh golems have stand firm, because could have done a cheeky chain push play here potentially, but without it, it ain't gonna happen, is it? Kind of relying on knocking that fleshy down somehow, Danker. Might bolt this and then get two dice on the ghoul. It's an option, isn't it? Potentially. But he's down. Oh! Imagine if he'd won in 81 that block. Holy shit. Yeah, but it's a pretty huge turn, isn't it? I think I'm definitely going to try to blitz the ghoul. The only thing is, I've basically got to fucking knock over the fucking flesh golems. That's the bastard here. Got to knock over. It's reliant on knocking over flesh golems. But if I can block him, and block him, then he can come 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, GFI or something. And blitz him, and I can just foul him anyway with him. 1, 2, 3, 4, GFI. Alright, let's go for the wizard. Okay, and I can foul him as well, maybe. Right. This is a one dice, isn't it? So I've got to power him first. Might as well stand him up. Of course I don't power him. Of course I don't power him. Finally power him. Now I've got to power him. Alright. So he can go there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 GFI. And then blitz him. So I don't have to make the 1 and 9 block, do I? Can't foul. Fuck. it can foul. Unfucking believable. Well, that was about as bad a turn as you can get, wasn't it, eh? I'll go for the Windbleeding Hippie, because to finish top four, you basically need a lot of die. You need a lot of wins to finish top four. So, fucking hell. The good thing is that it's not so easy for him to surf. Because that makes his touchdown harder, doesn't it? I'll definitely go for the win. If I get the chance. If he scores turn 12 or 13, I'll go for the win. Of course I will. That's why you want your opponent to score. If he scores turn 14, I'll still have... If he scores 15, I've still got three turns. I'll still go for it. Yes, of course, VIP, the way tricks. But it went about as bad as... That's why I said about as bad as it could have gone. In that I've risked... You know, I've used a reroll. All of my players are in bad positions. And I achieved diddly squat. In that respect, it's gone pretty fucking badly. Hello, Coach Cookie. I don't care if my ghouls die, but this was bad, wasn't it? Giving up this block, that was another bad thing. If I just powered him, then I could have. If I powered him, I could have pushed him instead. So instead, I give up the block on him, which gets KO'd. So it went pretty badly that turn. That was pretty bad. If I just powered him, I'd have pushed him to there, gone him, and he would have gone there, and it'd been all right. Yeah, he already had one. Already had four. Diddly squat. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's obviously objectively it's not going terribly at the moment, but I did use my wizard. I did use my 150k to not remove the strength four and not get the ball loose. So it was a risky foul, but I just had to foul him, didn't I? I wanted to have powered earlier. If I'd powered him earlier, this guy would have come and done the foul with an assist instead of not. 1, 2, 3, 4, GFI fouled him. Would have been great, but I just couldn't knock down this fuckhead. And then if I'd powered him the first one, he could have blocked him, and then my mummy could have come in to assist here, and then this guy could have gone for it and fouled and stuff. I had lots of options if I hadn't just not knocked over the... You know, the stand firm guys, which is fair enough, and his block wouldn't have helped defensively there, but the guard did help, so the guard's paying off for him there that turn. The good thing is that if he surfs, he's in a bit of a bad spot, isn't he? Yeah, Jellyl is in chat though, so let's not give him ideas here. But yeah, he could potentially, but it's risky, isn't it? It's risky as fuck. It's still pretty risky from here. I don't know what his plan is now. He hasn't. No, unbelievably visceral. All right. So. If I blitz with a guard and push him, it's not good enough. I want him to go 1, 2, 3, 4 and then block. Which means a pow is required. Got him. Right. If I one dice him here. I want to try and pow him. I think I fucked that up a little bit, actually. I think maybe I should have blitzed there and got the guard in. Now I need to what, one dice him there to get a push, or push him to there, and then blitz him on one dice to get there. That's not even good. Blitz him, push him, stand there, block him on two dice, get the push. No, so I want to get a surf, that's the thing, but it ain't going to work, is it? If I could have freed him up to go there, then he could have blitzed there and then got in. Alright, come on. Come on, lad. Got him. Right, so now if I block him with him, it leaves the agility for free to go get it, doesn't it? Which is good. Wow, holy fucking shit. I fucked up that turn though, I'm pretty sure. This would be a heroic play, wouldn't it, to do this? Fuck it. Oh yeah. Get banged on. Yeah, now I get the pow. Stun. Holy shit, he's not just headless, he's completely invisible. He's got no arms and no legs as well. Holy shit, that was pretty cool. Oh man, GFI to foul there would have been sweet, wouldn't it? What a hero. Actually, it was 50-50, wasn't it? I mean, to make the dodge. But, and look, in that situation, well, if he'd failed, he fucking fails. It's not the end of the world, is it? But if he makes it, Managed to stun his strength 4. He's getting fouled next turn. If he doesn't score this turn, this cunt's getting fouled. Dodging like Lupak. Absolutely, Cookie. Absolutely. Yeah, it's weird. I've completely, like, obviously the first half I was crazy with the amount of removals I made that made it like an academic touchdown almost. And then this time, it's just been 8 dice on the ball, no both down. The reason that I didn't care about tackle was he hasn't got block on his carrier, has he? If he had block on his carrier, then, they weren't 80% Vistral, because I don't have tackle, so it was like, they were, I guess 80% overall, yeah, 55, yeah. Yeah, 8 dice, so yeah, they were both 80%, yeah. Yeah, 80% overall. Hello, Tony plays poorly. 8 dice on him. Yeah, each block was a 55%. Again, VIP Bleeding Hippie. He is in chat, so please, let's keep the coaching to a minimum. Yeah, 80% with reroll, yeah. Holy shit. So, chance of failing those two is pretty small, isn't it? So, like, 80% of 80 is what, 96%? To have gotten him down. I would have liked to have gotten him down. But even if he scores this turn, I've still got 4 turns to score with a reroll. It's not that crazy. Like, it's doable, isn't it? It's doable to score. He is down to 10. I might have 11. Maybe. So, it's still doable even if he scores here. Hello, Eurodyne. Yep, the game is still alive and kicking. He was in a bit of a bad spot, but he's managed to, wow, he's just gone for the blitz double GFI to score, but I think he's just gone for the score, isn't he? Tripwiring the GFI would be justice for all of the failed blocks on him. There you go. Alright. maybe Tony, maybe. Hello, Dr. Bananas. Right, need my Pommer back. Need him, yes. So still got 11. 11 versus 9. 3, 6, 9. With Mighty Blow and Pom hits on the line. But the thing is, only one reroll for 4 turns. So using the wizard to force the score isn't so bad. Yeah, you could have switched and hand off to the white. Yeah, true. That'd give you more chance for stall. But ghouls are fast. I could have still got back. But yeah. Yeah, it wasn't risky. Yeah, good point, Jaleel. It wasn't really risky. I did inducement cheat to get a wizard, yeah. Bad form. Yeah, I inducement cheated to get the wizard. Absolutely, Carlo Ancelotti. There's no way in the potentially fucking group and playoff deciding game, there's no way I'm not going to cheat a wizard. I'll cheat a wizard against Ducky if I can. Yeah, the blitz as well, because that's a 1 in 3, wasn't it? The blitz was pretty risky. It's doable. The only thing is the one reroll and lack of block, isn't it, on the mummies? Because obviously I wanna be hitting with mummies if I can. I wanna be 3 Dyson with them. Yeah. 4 turns is doable, and I've still got the bribe, so that's good. Getting some fouls in. Right. So now these guys want to go here, don't they? But it requires moving in a zombie to assist. Obviously, he wants to blitz him. And yeah, all right, let's go. Hopefully he doesn't get a blitz. If he does get a blitz, these are all free. He's free. So blitz wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Heat, when it doesn't matter. That's the best time for heat, isn't it? Fucking load of shit heat is. Right. Okay, so I can't reroll anything realistically. He can't surf him. So get these back over the ball. He's pretty much committed to blitzing over there now. I'm not going to follow. Injured, good. Wish I'd done that. Wish I'd done that first half. Would have made the second half easier, wouldn't it? All right, he can go there. Can three dice this one. Wow. I have to use my reroll because it's actually pretty crucial, isn't it? If I go down there, it would have been really bad. Fuck's sake. Oh, man. I should have gone for the pickup first. Fucking hell. Bit shit, I have to use the reroll. Should have gone for the pickup first. yeah, I should have gone for the pickup first because I just couldn't afford to not have the ball with only four turns to score. So I think I definitely fucked up making that safe three dice block. Even the two dice block, I should have probably just gone for the fucking pickup because I had to make that pickup that turn, didn't I? Then get to the halfway line and then move forward and score. So that was pretty dumb. Hope you dice your way to victory, yeah. Pretty much. No foul. Didn't get to do a foul either. Pardon me. Oh, man. No rerolls. Holy shit. Yeah, he's 8, I think. 4, 7. No, 7. Did I get 2 people? Oh, yeah, I killed someone, didn't I? Killed him. Well, I didn't kill him, but, you know, badly hurt. Yeah, all right, 7 players is good. Yeah, all mans is clearly the play. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's no GFI. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No GFIs. I've got to deal with this fucking golem, don't I? That's what matters, is the golems. I need to get protection out in front of him as well. Realistically. Two D him with block seems good. Thank you very much. Right, I gotta make this 3D, don't I? And then if I make the 3D, he comes into here. He blitzes and he fouls. So this is the next safest move. Injured. Holy shit. Wow. Stunned. So, do I foul this guy? Try to tag him. Block him down. Probably best just to block the tackler, isn't it? Oh god, that's not a followed up. Oh, no. Yeah, I didn't see that. Followed up, I didn't mean to follow up with a mummy. Yeah, mummy wasn't actually meant to follow up. Yeah, I know, Carlo Ancelotti, I know, I fucked up. Absolutely fucked up. Shouldn't have followed up with a mummy. Shit. And now he knows because he's reading chat probably, fuck's sake. The dangers of streaming. I'll say from this guy, I just fucking didn't think about not following. Obviously, I meant to not follow with him. Fuck me. Yeah, one more for the white level, yeah. True, good point. Yeah, he's got it now, he's seen it now. He's just going to make his 5 plus here. No, not yet. Good. Good, I think that's fair after all the fucking hits I had in his career that his one dice didn't work. I think that's fair, to be honest. Oh, funny scouts. Oh, he's done for. Oh, God. Right. Right. Do I 3 die or 2 die? The 2 die has less chance of failure. 3. Oh. I think I have to 3 die. Just so I can get the protection for him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He's going to foul, isn't he? No, he's going to stand up for the assist there. Alright. Don't 1 in 27 this, you fucking piece of shit. Unbelievable. Unfucking believable. Unfucking believable. Unfucking believable, isn't it? Bet your fucking house on that. If I just hadn't rerolled the hits on the ball, which actually didn't matter. They didn't cost me the game, did they? Those hits on the ball. I shouldn't reroll the hits on the ball. Unbelievable. Two died, dodge would have given better odds. Because I needed the ghoul for protection, didn't I? I guess this guy could have blitzed, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah. He could have blitzed and then dodged out if it failed. Yeah, alright, I misplayed. At least he can't score, at least I haven't lost. But I wanted him to be able to go down, and of course he just piles three dice. Three dice and gets the power. I had eight dice and didn't. Man, so for all these cars and all the KOs, which obviously makes it look like I was the luckiest guy in the world, it actually... The crucial dice have been failures, haven't they? The ones that mattered have gone wrong. Not much chance without a reroll. Right, so obviously we want a blitz with him. 4, 5, 6, 7. Just go for the pass is going to be better, isn't it? So block him so he can't intercept. Get him out of the way. I want to push him to there, don't I? It's going to be better. So one GFI. Alright, GG. Holy shit. And it was the guy who gets a level as well. Holy shit. My god. Yeah, open up the ball was a mistake, yeah. And not picking up first was a mistake, yeah. True, Vellini. Yeah. I did make mistakes, yeah. That's true, that's true. But I still... I failed 8 dice on the ball. 8 dice on the ball, didn't I? I failed. Which, obviously, I only got because of all the removals and stuff. No, I didn't actually, because he had a full 11 in the second half. But I only got because I bought the wizard. But that was frustrating, not getting knocked down from 8 dice on the ball. He got knocked down from 3 dice on the ball. But his were the same chance of knocking down because my ball carrier had block. But yeah, Bloodbowl does take you through the fucking tumbler, doesn't it? To my turn 16s in this league, yeah, I got lucky in the end, obviously, making that without, 2-2, 2-3 without a reroll was intense. Yep, GG Shaeffer, definitely. Yeah, those two mistakes. Yeah, it was those two mistakes that let him back into it. Absolutely, Vellinek, yeah. It was my fault. It was my fault he had a chance. It was my fault he had a chance. Whereas it was the dice fault that he had no chance to stop my drive. I mean, he had no chance to stop my drive, did he? With the 3 KOs on turn 1. Basically gave him no chance at all to stop my drive. Malibu's all around. Yeah, nice winnings. I mean, 18 AV breaks, that says it all, doesn't it? I didn't get to foul in the second half that I saved my drive for, and I didn't even really get to foul in the second half. But yeah, I really fucked up by following up with a mummy. That was terrible. And fucked up by not going for the pickup. But, you know, if I'd made the pickup, I might have rolled a 1 and then had to use it then. Right, double or strength or something? No. Probably sidestep, I reckon. I really do like sidestep. It could be tackle, though, really, for when you think my remaining game's against Ducky, who's going to have some dodge on his guys, isn't he? Ducky and Hon, they've both got quite a lot of dodge. So maybe I could take something there to deal with them. And a lot of money so that I'll be able to buy a wizard against Ducky, which is always nice, isn't it? Always nice to be able to buy a wizard against Ducky. Well, should be able to unless I roll a 2 for winnings. 30 for that mummy now, 29 for him. So hopefully level both of those for the game against Ducky. Hopefully level him and him. There's a lot of players near a level, isn't there? I'll sack him, obviously, and another guy as well, probably. I've got the Agility 4, so the Agility 4 guy's the one who's going to get your hands to run. So, Frenzy. No, I'm not going to get Frenzy. Yeah. Yeah, that brain fart in your drive. Yeah, that was a killer, wasn't it, Shaeffer? That was an absolute killer. The brain fart on your drive, yeah, which is what led to the 8 dice on the ball, wasn't it? So, yeah. So thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and stay fantastic.